What up, guys? It's just like, and today we're reading Steve Folks. We're reading it from Anna's perspective. So, let's begin. I do love to sit and look out the window. Why do I need a TV when I have 48 apartment windows to wash across the vacant lot and the silver lake, and the silver of Lake Erie? I've seen history out this window so much. I was 4 when we moved here in 1919. The fruit sellers' carts and coal wagons were pulled down the street by horses back then. I used to stand just here and watch the coal brought up by a handsome lad from Grozen, the village my parents were born in. Gibb Street was mainly ruminants back then. It was Ido, goodbye, in all the shops when you left. Then the ruminants started leaving. They weren't the first or the last. This has always been a working class neighborhood. It's like a cheap hotel. You stay until you've got enough money to leave. A lot of Slovaks and Italians moved in next. Then Negro families in the Depression. Gibb Street became the line between the blacks and the whites, like a border between countries. I watched it happen through this very window. I lived over in Cleveland Heights for 18 years. Then I moved back in to take care of my parents, the ward I moved to. Most of the whites left. Then the steel mills and factories closed, and everybody left, like rats. Buildings abandoned, men with no work, drinking from 9 to 5 instead, down there in the lot. Always a siren, people killing each other. Now I see families from Mexico and Cambodia and countries I don't even know. 12 people sometimes in one apartment. New languages in the shops and on the street. These new people leave when they can, like others. I'm the only one that's staying. It's so. Staying and staring out this same window. This spring I looked out and saw something strange. Down in the lot, a little black-haired girl heading behind the refrigerator. She was looking at the dirt and looking around suspiciously all the time. Then I realized she was burying something. I never had children of my own, but I've seen enough of it in that lot to know that she was mixed up in something she shouldn't be. After 20 years typing for the patrol department, I just knew what she buried. Drugs, most likely, or money, or a gun. The next moment, she disappeared like a rabbit. I thought of calling up the police. Then I saw her the next morning, and I decided I'd solve this case myself. With a long spell of rain then, I didn't set eyes on her once. Then the weather turned warm, and I saw her twice more, always in the morning, on her way to school. She was crouched down with her back to me, so I couldn't see just what she was doing. My curiosity was like a fever inside me. Then one morning, she was there, glancing about, and she looked straight up at this window. I pulled my head back behind the curtain. I wasn't sure if she'd seen me. If she had, she wouldn't leave her treasure buried long. Then I knew I'd have to dig it up before she did. I waited an hour after she left. Then I took an old butter knife and my cane and hobbled down on 3 flights of stairs. I worked my way through the awful jungle of junk and finally came to her spot. I stooped down. It was wet there, easy digging. I hacked and dug. I didn't find anything except for a large white bean. I tried a new spot and found another, and a third. Then the truth of it slapped me full in the face. I said to myself, "What have you done?" 2 beans had roots. I knew I'd done them harm. I felt like I'd read through her secret diary. I'd read through her secret diary and had ripped out a page without meaning to. I laid those beans right back in the ground, as gently as sleeping babies. Then I patted the soil as smooth as it could be. The next morning, she was back. I peeked around the curtain. She didn't look up here or even give a sign that she noticed something wrong. I could see her clearly at this time. She reached a hand in her school bag. Then she pulled out a jar, unscrewed the lid, and poured out water on the ground. That afternoon, I bought some binoculars. Hope you guys enjoyed this chapter, person's perspective, or whatever it is. Hope you guys enjoyed it. If you guys did, remember to leave a like, subscribe, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye!